Alright, what is going on everyone? It is Super here, and I'm bringing you guys another Mortal Kombat X video, and I'm bringing you guys another How to Play video. This time we're going to be focusing on Sub-Zero. And Sub-Zero is a pretty basic and pretty solid character. And I think in Grandmaster, which is a variation that I know a little bit about, not too much, but I think in Grandmaster he is one of the best characters in the game, especially in the corner. Once Grandmaster gets in the corner, you're pretty much fucked. But I'm here to talk about mostly Cryomancer and Unbreakable because I do have experience with Unbreakable and I think it's a fun variation to use and underrated variation. So let's get started here. Whenever someone tells me, because I do get new subscribers every day and new people watch my videos, so whenever someone tells me what character should I pick up, I just got this game and you know I don't know too much about Mortal Kombat and I want to pick a character that is easy to pick up and learn. And I always tell them to learn Sub-Zero, mostly Cryomancer Sub-Zero, because I think it's pretty much the most basic variation in the game, or Sub-Zero in general is the most basic character. He is really safe, he has a lot of safe stuff, and he is easy to use. So let's get started talking about Sub-Zero. Some of his best pokes, down 4. You guys see it every time. Whenever you play against a Sub-Zero, what does he start with? Down 4, because it has so much range, and it's going to beat a lot of down 4s that try to, you know, that your opponent tries to use, because his down 4 is top 5 in the game. It is really good. Of course, the low profiles, things, and down 4, down 4, down 4, Sub-Zero, guys. As far as other pokes, let's see, his standing one is 7 frames, so this is definitely one of what you want to use to punish. So if you're up close and you want to punish your opponent, in Cryomancer you could actually go 1-1-1 into Ice Ball. In Grandmaster and Unbreakable, what you're going to want to do is just 1-1 into Ice Ball, because you know, in Cryomancer he gets extra hit because of the sword in which you can combo. So what you want to use to punish people, 1-1 into Ice Ball. Cryomancer, 1-1-1 into Ice Ball. His back 2 is an 11 frame mid. It's pretty good. It's not the best in the world. You know, as you guys see, it doesn't have too much range. It doesn't, you know, cover. Actually, it's decent. You know, I don't see a lot of Sub-Zeros using this unless it's, you know, as a punish or as a whiff punish, and you know, pretty much trying to hit confirm into the Ice Ball. You know, that's gonna be your best bet in hit confirming into the Ice Ball. It's gonna lead to the most amount of damage other than the overhead. So you know, back one is still a mid, it's still 11 frame mid, so you know, you definitely want to use this, especially for a combo start. It's really, really good. Next up here, what's this? I don't know, that's not good at all. His down 1 is 9 frames, and I believe his down 4 is 9 frames, right? Yeah, his down 4 is 9 frames, so why would you want to poke with this when you could poke with his down 4? And his down 4 low profiles some stuff, so, you know, what you want to use with Sub-Zero is, I don't use down 1 a lot, maybe in some situations, but why would I use down 1 when I have down 4 when they're the same amount of frames, and this one's a low and it low profiles some stuff that might not get low profiled by his down 1. Another button that he has down 4, which I believe is 7 frames. No, it is actually 9 frames, but it's only minus 1 on block, so it's really good. If your opponent's not ready to counter poke, you guys see some Sub-Zeros, they like doing this. And this is not real, but if your opponent's not ready to counter poke, you get someone with 2 of these, and then you know, you can start your offense. What is this? It's plus 14 on hits, so it's actually very good, man. Down 3, 9 frames, only minus 1, and it's plus 14 on hits. So you know, you get someone with one of these, you could go into your overhead or your low. So you know, definitely a good solid poke. What's down 4 on hit? Down 4 is 17 frames, so yeah, definitely really good. So it's forward 4. His forward 4 is actually a very good mid, because it's 12 frames and it has so much range. As you guys see here, it has a character length range, and I'm pretty sure, yeah, a little bit beyond character length, like a tiny bit beyond character length. And of course you could, you know, hit confirm this into, you know, a lot of things, into the EX Hammer to give you extra damage. You know, it leads to that in Grandmaster and in Unbreakable. You could combo into EX Ice Ball and, you know, go into your combo. So this right here, really good, especially if you want to whiff punish somebody. If your opponent is doing a move already or a combo and you know you're going to be able to whiff punish him, you know, you could go into that. Well, in Cryomancer, you could, you know, do the hammer. But in the other ones, you're going to want to do the meter burn ice ball because that's the best, you know, confirm. You could also do this if, you know, just for a cheeky 13% damage, maybe to end the game and stuff. You know, it's a two-hitter. A lot of times your opponent's not going to break fast enough. So, you know, it's pretty much what I'm trying to say is that forward four is a good tool for Sub-Zero. And, of course, it leads to this. Forward two. 1+3, and you know, in Cryomancer, it's one of the best things. So now let's go into, am I forgetting anything? All right, so forward three, here we go. This is what I'm talking about right here. This is actually very good. This is a 9-frame mid by Sub-Zero that leads into forward 3-3 into a safe combo. So, and the middle of the combo, you could actually special cancel. So you could special cancel, you know, forward three, and you could special cancel forward 3-3, but only on the second hit, only here, because you cannot special cancel after he does the last hit. Special cancel the second hit, not the last hit. So, you know, that's good to know. Forward three is a 9-frame mid. So, you know, whenever you have a mid that's that fast, it's very good. As you guys see, down four, down three, forward three, forward four. His down two is not good. I will say that. Back one. A lot of good buttons for Sub-Zero. So now let's talk a little bit about, you know, some basic combos for Cryomancer. Actually, before that, I want to talk about the slide. I think Sub-Zero's slide is the move that is that low profiles the most. Like, it has the smallest hitbox of a crouching, you know, character in the game. As you guys see, he goes really low, and you know, the slide is a great tool. It is, I believe it's 8 frames, right? It's a 9-frame move, and it goes about 3/4 of the screen. It's really fast, and it's good for going under projectiles. Like, let's just say Katana's fans are highs. You know, if you catch Katana doing a fan, you could go right under it and punish your opponent for 8%. And of course, they're knocked down. And with Cryomancer, with his 50-50s, you go for the overhead with the low, you know, run up and grab. The slide is just a beautiful tool for Sub-Zero. He's had it since the beginning, and it's always been good, and it will continue to be good because it is a classic move. It's really fucking good. And of course, if your opponent's throwing out mid projectiles, you could always do meter burn, and that's 11% right there. So the slide is really, really good, man. It goes throughout across all three variations. That's why I want to talk about it. So don't just throw out the slide whenever, because a lot of times people expect Sub-Zero to do the slide, because the slide is like the number one option for reversal for Sub-Zero. Something else that you can use instead of that, if you're this close to your opponent, is this, which is down back one. It sends them into a launching state, so you can follow it up with a slide, and you could even follow it up with forward four into, you know, a combo for Cryomancer, or, you know, forward 4-2 into slide for Unbreakable and Grandmaster. So this is another option. If you don't want to do the slide, this is actually a lot safer. I have never been punished for using this, even though it says that it's like minus 12 or minus 11, something like that. I've never been punished for using this because it adds a lot of pushback. So now let's go into some actual combos. So as you guys know, 1-1-1 into Ice Ball with Cryomancer is your best punish. And then jump in, overhead, run cancel a little bit into forward 4-2, 1+3. It's actually a string. I'll show you guys right now. Where are you? There you go. This string right here, this is actually specific for Cryomancer. It lets you special cancel at the end. you know, you could do a special move afterwards, so you could actually extend your combo more. That was one of the buffs that they gave to Cryomancer, which makes Cryomancer a juggernaut as far as damage, because you could get some pretty high damaging combos, especially off overheads. But this ring right here, this is what you want to end your string with. This is what you want to end your combos with every single time with Cryomancer. Forward 4, 2, 1 plus 3 into either hammer. Actually, yeah, into hammer. There's like nothing else. The hammer does the most amount of damage for Cryomancer. So let me just show you guys something that you would get off. Let's just say you land a back 3-3, which is this. It's a double low, really, really good. So you go back 3-3, EX hammer, back 2, run cancel a little bit, do your string, and then you end it with a hammer. Bam, 36%, easy. Easy combos. And let's just say you get an overhead. You hit someone with an overhead, you go into your combo, EX hammer, go into the combo again, and 43%, even easier than the first combo. So these are like the bread and butter combos for Sub-Zero. You know, this is a good punish. Jump in, overhead, run cancel a little bit, or run a little bit, and forward 4, 2, 1 plus 3 into hammer. This is what you want to end all your combos with, this right here. And like I said, if you get an overhead, do this into an EX hammer. And then you don't have to run cancel after that. You just, you know, as soon as a person goes up, you press forward 4, combo again, and end it with a regular hammer, and you're going to get that juicy 43%. Let's do it again. Messed up right there. There you go. And something else that you can do, even though if it's a late game situation, I would recommend it. But other than that, maybe in the corner I would recommend it too, because it could get up to 52%, I believe. But you could put an EX ice ball at the end of the second string and then go into the string again for an extra, I believe, 5% mid-screen. Let's see. How much damage is it? 48. Alright, so you get an extra 5%. Like I said, if it's a game-ending situation and you know that the opponent's going to be left with a little bit of health, you know, and you have an extra bar of meter, burn that meter for the EX Ice Ball, and it's going to net you 5 extra percent. That could be, you know, the determining factor of the game. In the corner, if you do that same combo, you go overhead. Actually, you want two overheads in the corner. I'll show you guys right now, because two overheads, you get a fuckload of damage. So if you catch someone in the corner with Cryomancer, of course you have this and you have the overhead. And you guys know about this combo already. You know, it's pretty much the same in the corner. You know, bam, 36%, not too shabby. But if you land an overhead in the corner, you could actually get two overheads into the forward four combo. So you go one overhead, one overhead, two overheads, EX hammer. And then you go into your forward four combo again. And 47% off an overhead. One bar of meter, which a lot of characters even struggle sometimes to get it to 40% with one bar. And Cryomancer, 47% in the corner. Double overhead. It gets a little tricky online, but it doesn't stop there. You could actually get even more damage. You throw an EX ice ball after this, you jump in, forward four combo into hammer, 52% with two bars. Really good for game ending situations where your opponent has no breakers, they have under 50% health. Really, really good if you have them in the corner and you catch them with an overhead. So that is pretty much it for Cryomancer. Pretty simple. You're always going to want to end your combos in this, guys. Just remember, hammer, it does a lot of damage, man, a lot of damage. Of course, if you get a whiff punish and you want to, you know, you have the ability to use back one into ice ball. This in the corner, obviously, double overhead in the corner, 36% mid-screen. Mid-screen. Same thing. Yurtz is gonna get one. You could meter burn it to get a little extra damage, 40%. Something else that you can do is a reset with Sub-Zero. This right here, forward 1-2, is actually very, very good because it is plus 29. That's a lot. That's a lot of plus frames, guys. That's a lot of plus frames. So, for example, let's see. Let's just say you jump and you get someone with this, and you want to reset them. You do forward 2, and then you're plus 29. You could go for overhead or low. So, pretty much after an ice ball, jump in, forward 1, and this leaves you plus 29. And, you know, if you're obviously going to do it right at the start, so you're still going to be in range for your back 3-3 and your overhead. So, you know, that's just something to keep in mind if you actually get someone with, you know, maybe a jump in, you get them with this, and late game situation, you want to try to reset them for the win, you know, you could do that, bam, reset, this is how much, 17%, let's just say you land the overhead, you have a bar of meter, and that would have been like 38%, 40% almost. Yeah, it probably would have been 40%, 43%. So, resets are always nice, man. They're just nice to have. So, you know, forward 1-2 leaves you plus 29. And, of course, you can go for this. You could always, you know, go back 3-3 for the low. So, that's Cryomancer, guys. Let's talk a little bit about Unbreakable. And Unbreakable is... he's fun, but it's tough to use, man. So the main like difference between these three variations, or you know, Unbreakable to the other ones, is you get a parry. This right here, you can hold it a little bit. Actually, you can't hold it. Yeah, you can't hold it. This comes out at 6 frames. Parry. Yeah, 6 frames, and the meter burn one comes out at 3 frames. So you know, if you find yourself going up against someone who has a gap in their string, and it's, you know, 3 frames, you could EX it. If it's 6 frames, you could do that, and you know, it's gonna catch them. I don't believe this is armored. I just think it comes out faster. Well, I don't really think he needs armor because of the fucking barriers in front of him, but a lot of times, guys, I'm not gonna lie, I find myself not using this because it is so punishable if your opponent does not fall for it. Look at it. I'm holding block the whole time. Do you guys see how long it takes my character to actually block after this? To me, the risk reward is not worth it. Because if you get this, you're going to get a 15% up to maybe 25% combo at the most. And if your opponent doesn't fall for it, you're going to be eating, I don't know, man, depending on what character it is, a bunch of fucking damage. So I don't find this parry to be all that great. If Sub-Zero recovered a lot faster from the parry, it would be really good. But since the recovery time takes so long, you're gonna get punished every single time, and the risk reward for using this is not worth it for me. You know, it feels good to catch someone with it. I'm not gonna lie, if someone is trying to do a move and you bust this out and you freeze them, it feels so rewarding. But, you know, to me, it's not worth it. Like, when I did a highlight video of Unbreakable, I'll link that in the description if you guys want a more in-depth Unbreakable. You know, I didn't use this that much. The second thing that is different with this one is he actually gets an aura. It's down back 3, and this right here actually causes you to take less chip. So actually it causes you to take no chip. So the regular aura, when you have it on, let's just say for example Tanya does a lot of chip damage with the Rekka. If she starts doing that when you have your aura on, it's not gonna do absolutely any chip, and the EX win is like super fast. It's like a one frame move. Look at how fast it is. Look at the difference. Regular aura, EX aura, regular aura, regular aura, EX aura, could punch immediately. And you could do some, you could actually link stuff that I'll show you guys right now, but whenever you have the EX aura, you actually take less damage and no chip. and it lasts for about 10 seconds, I believe. So, you know, it can be really useful, especially against those characters, like I said, who do a lot of chip damage. Having no chip damage dealt to you is really fucking good. So now let's see. Let's say you get a jump in and you go forward one, back 1-2. You could actually hit confirm back 1-2 into the regular aura and then do a 1-1 ice ball, which is pretty cool. Let's see if I can get this. As you guys see, all this comboed, and you have your aura. It is still going to be here when you're here in the corner, and you hit confirmed it into a combo, so it's pretty nice to have, man. Let's just say you get this. You could go back 1-2, regular aura, 1-2-3 into slide, and as you guys see, you get, you know, nice 25% damage. That's another thing about this variation that I talked about. You don't get damage at all. This is like mostly a defensive variation, pretty much. So that's pretty much it. The EX aura is actually going to grant you a lot of plus frames, especially if you do the EX aura after forward 4. Forward 4 on block, EX aura, or forward 4 EX aura on block actually leaves Sub-Zero plus a lot. Like, your opponent can't move. He's just stuck there. So he has to take the 50-50, take your overhead, take your low, or you could go in for a grab. So a lot of times when I wanted to pressure somebody and I had a bar of meter, you know, I would do forward 4 into EX aura, and he had to take my 50-50 or my grab. So, you know, EX aura is really, really good. It's just, you know, really meter dependent. For Sub-Zero, this variation that has no good anti-airs, you're going to want to save your bar of meter for this right here, because this is actually a really good anti-air. And, you know, you're going to be spending your bar on that. And, you know, this one is just really meter dependent, which really, really sucks. But, you know, you could actually you could convert anything into your overhead, which is the most damaging thing Sub-Zero could do with the EX aura. So back 1-2, overhead, all that combo, 3-3, back 3-3, that comboed. I don't know if you can get that one. I'm pretty sure you can. Nah, I'm doing it too early. It doesn't look like you can combo that one. Yeah, I'm doing it too early right now. Yeah, it doesn't look like you combo that one, but pretty much off your 50-50s and off your back 1-2, you could connect overhead after EX aura, and it actually leaves you plus on block when you do this or this as well. So that's going to be it for Unbreakable. Grandmaster, sorry guys, I'm not even going to go into it. I know a little bit about the variation, but not enough to teach you guys anything. So, you know, I hope you guys learned a little bit about Unbreakable more. Like I said, if you want to learn even more, like more in depth, make sure you guys go check out my highlight video. It's going to be linked in the description, like the very first link, because I talk more about, like, I pretty much like show you gameplay against people. This is more just like a basic tutorial on these characters. But remember, whenever you get a jump in and you do back 1-2, you could do regular aura and get extra damage by comboing it into, you know, 1-1 into ice ball. So, you know, I think Unbreakable could be a really good variation. Each just needs a little bit more. Maybe do something more with the parry. Make it a little bit faster, or not faster. It's already, you know, pretty fast. Make it recover. Give it like faster recovery. You know what I mean? Like, look at all this time that the opponent has. Crazy, crazy, crazy. And especially with some characters that have, you know, 9 frame mids that advance forward, you know, it could get really tough for poor little Unbreakable. So that's going to be it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys next time.